It's March and I am starting my pantry clean out project, and today I was going through my cabinets and found some ingredients that I need some fresh ideas for. So I'm gonna show them to you guys and hopefully you can help me. Hey everybody, it's Amanda and I am very excited to get my kitchen just kind of refreshed, revamped this March. So today is the first day and I'm trying to start, like I do pretty much anything that I do in my kitchen, and I started with an inventory. So I was going through everything in my cabinets, just trying to get a handle on what I have and thinking about what kind of meals I can make with it. And there are some things that I ran into that I want to kind of look at with fresh eyes, because I either have a lot of it or I just have a few and I just don't have any ideas on how to use it. So I'm bringing it to you and hopefully you can help me just get some fresh ideas. So I have just a handful of things over here. I'm gonna show them to you. And I would love for you to share with me in the comments some fresh ideas. I really need some. So let me show you what we have. Okay, so you can see that there's just a few items here. And these are all things that I actually have recipes that I know how to make with them, but for whatever reason I'm just kind of wanting something different. So the first thing I have are these pineapple chunks, and I gotta be honest with you, when I eat pineapple I generally speaking buy a fresh pineapple. I don't know what possessed me to get these pineapple chunks, but they've been sitting there and I'm not using them. So I'm really looking for some kind of recipe that is, I don't know, interesting. Now here's the thing, we love Asian food and Brian loves pineapple on pizza, so if I run out of ideas, it's gonna be my backup. But I just feel like I could probably do something more exciting with it. Let me know if you have any ideas on pineapple chunks. No idea on that one. Okay, so this is my next item, and it's an organic condensed tomato soup. And again, I could just use it as tomato soup, but I really feel like you could probably use it as some ingredients. So you'll notice on the top, I spilled some flour on it. Some of the other ones, but I've actually used this before in like a beef stew, but I feel like there's more that can be done. And I'm sure you guys have some ideas of some things that are exciting rather than just eating it as soup. So throwing this out here, let me just let you know. Chickpeas, y'all. I have a bunch of chickpeas. I probably have 10 cans of this. And of course I've made roasted chickpeas and I've made chickpea curry. But what else can you do? Hummus, I know that. Is there more that you know and you're thinking to yourself, I've got the most awesome chickpea recipe? There's actually a BuzzFeed video where she makes a bunch of different things with chickpeas, and I watched that and I'm still not inspired. So this is just another one of those things that I think probably a lot of people have in their pantry and don't know what to do with. So chickpeas, let me know what you have. All right, peanut butter. If you guys watched my grocery haul where I showed you that my neighbor gave me a bunch of peanut butter, then you know I have probably 7 jars of this. And I recently found out that my husband has an allergy and cannot have these. So it has to be something that like me and Brianna and Brian can have and just kind of use up this peanut butter. I'd rather it not be all like peanut butter cookies or peanut butter brownies, you know, something. There's gotta be other ways to use it that are more, I mean, I don't want to say health conscious, because peanut butter is in my mind, you know, you're gonna use it in like granola or snacks or things, but there's gotta be something better than just cookies and snacks. So let me know your awesome ideas for peanut butter. I love to hear them. Speaking of which, this right here I know is gonna be a challenge, because I mean, frankly, it's butterscotch. It's probably going to be used in a cookie or a cake or something like that. But I just want to use it in a way that's interesting. So I'm definitely open to ideas on this. Really have no concept other than probably the cookie on the bag. But I don't want to make a lot of cookies and snacks. I want to use this, you know, in an interesting way. Let me know your thoughts. Just share with me your thoughts. Balsamic vinegar. You know, I asked you guys about this before a little while ago. And I still have a bunch of it left, and I'm just looking for ideas. I don't know what it is. I just never really used balsamic until probably the last few years. And I have a very, very limited number of recipes that I use with balsamic. So tell me what you love. Tell me what is necessary in your life. Because I have a lot of this and I want to use it. And it's got a really interesting flavor, and I want to expand my recipe knowledge. Salmon, y'all. I've been getting this salmon because it is such a good deal. My husband loves salmon and we have been eating it, but I really make a great salmon, but we've had it the same way like every time, and there's got to be new ways to make salmon. So let me know. Awesome salmon recipes. The easier the better, and I'd love to hear it. And finally, the dried fruit and nut mix. I mean, obviously you can eat it like it is, right? You can just eat it as fruit and nuts. But I really feel like I could do something amazing with this. I mean, I probably put it in some muffins and things like that, but have you experimented with this? I might even do a full video of me doing multiple experiments with this because I have so many bags of this, it's ridiculous because again, my same neighbor gave it to me. But I want to use it and I want to use it well. I'd love to hear your thoughts. How do you use this, or how have you used it in the past? So this is the last item.
I know what you're thinking. Amanda, you could just go on Pinterest. And I could. But what I'm looking for are recipes that you guys enjoy that are tried and true. Because I feel like everybody that's here on this channel, you're folks who are like in your kitchens every day. You're like regular ladies and homemakers. And you know recipes that are like the ones that I need to have in my life. So I'm relying on you. I'm relying on your expertise, and I am very much looking forward to hearing your suggestions. So this is just my very first thing in my pantry clean out, because what I wanna do is I wanna try to get rid of anything like this that I'm struggling with making meals for, and just kind of work on getting a base of things that I am very comfortable with and building from there. So this is gonna be an interesting experience. I actually got some things on a side note. Since you're here, I'm just gonna tell you. My spice cabinet is looking rough because I haven't started my spice project yet, but I did get some labels. I decided to go with the ball canning jars, Sharpies, and I am going to be putting all of my spices in canning jars and getting them organized, and I'm so excited to share that with you. So anyway, so this is the first day of my pantry organization. And it's not just pantry organization, really, I'm cleaning the house, but the kitchen is where I gotta start because y'all know how it is. But anyway, all right, so that's it. Let me know your thoughts on these items. I am really looking forward to hearing what you have to say and what your suggestions are. And I might even do some videos of me trying the different recipes and see how that goes and see how the family likes it. So, all right. Well, thank you guys for joining me. I appreciate your help, and come back next time and we'll continue with all of our pantry organization. See you guys next time. Bye.